Hi there, this is Carlo from Flybubble. I'm here with the CHILI5, the new latest high B wing from Skywalk, which unsurprisingly they say is their best chili ever.
Welcome to the Flybubble Paragliding channel.
We are free flight experts and equipment specialists helping you get the best flying experience.
One of the key things that the CHILI5 has that the CHILI4 didn't, and the first time in the Skywalk range for their high B glider to have, is a BC system, what they call their speed control system, which is that system on the rear risers, where you can, on the speed system, use the rear risers to control your speed. CHILI5 comes in this very nice inner bag. I say very nice because it's nice quality. The material is great, the stitching is very high quality. And it has a nice zip part here, you can see, with mesh to let the glider breathe. Here we have the glider. New shiny glider. And a nice compression strap. Okay, time to get the glider out. Glider bag, little pack, stickers, the manual, printed manual. The sea riser there. And the brake handle, you can see the brake handle is got a little bit of stiffening in the bottom, nicely stitched at the bottom. The Mayons, these are the Mayon Rapide S style. Mayons are a little bit longer, with nice little plastic inserts to hold the lines in place and keep the Mayon from coming undone. And you can see the lines are all color coded. Now what we're going to do is I'm just going to play around with the CHILI5 on the ground and try and show you what it's like inflating and how it inflates, how it comes up. I'm on a bit of a slope and the wind's quite variable and gusty. It's actually pretty strong at the top of the hill, which is why I've come down. So yeah, it's going to be kind of testing conditions because, you know, the wind's varying around and dropping right off and coming through at times. So it'll be a good test. Skywalk CHILI5, its handling, I'd say, it's got the brake pressure is a moderate to light brake pressure. It's got a sort of moderate to longish travel, not short and it's not very long. The first part of the travel works very nicely for most of your turns and thermaling. The agility is kind of moderately agile. It's not a very agile glider, but it's not sort of too slow and planky either. It's somewhere in between. It does feel very taut and solid. It gives you a feeling, it's got a very reassuring feeling about it, quite calm. The feedback is moderate. It's not a high feedback glider, but it's not a sort of really dampened sort of glider that you can't feel what's happening either. It's kind of, yeah, in the middle of that sort of range. The glide is excellent. Across the speed range, I've been very impressed with it. I've been flying next to some very good pilots, actually some of the pilots in the British team on their Enzos, and of course they have more performance. I'm not saying it has that performance, but I've noticed that I've been able to stay with them in the climbs, and when we're gliding, it's not like they're just shooting away until they put the bar on, of course. Yeah, the CHILI5 is very pitch stable. When you're flying in active air, it actually sits above your head quite steadily. So that's very good. It doesn't have a lot of demand. You're not constantly having to catch the glider or it's pitching back. It's pretty steady above your head. It bites into thermals pretty nicely. The climb rate, so just in terms of sync rate, soaring on a hill when you're next to other gliders and you're just flying around, assuming we're reasonably similarly loaded, then soaring wise the Chili 5 does very well. You're definitely noticing that you're staying up near the top of the stack most of the time. I put the tendency slightly more on the in the weaker and moderate climbs. It climbs particularly well. In the stronger climbs, maybe it's got a little bit of a tendency to get knocked out a bit. You need to make sure that you're keeping in the core. That's my feeling. The speed bar is very light and efficient, comes on very smooth. You don't have a kind of heavy pressure to get it going. It's very light to push on, and all the way through the travel, you feel like you've got a nice feeling of how much bar you're putting on, and the glider speeds up nicely. BC control system, fairly usual kind of system that's got, it's got the risers, the ABC risers, and then a system of connectors between it. And the pressure I found is moderate to heavy. Like most of these BC systems, it's a little bit stiff. So you can certainly use it, and it works very effectively. It keeps the sail nice and clean, but it's on the heavier side. So it's difficult. I found it difficult. If it's very active, like suddenly active air, it's difficult to react quickly with that. So it's very good for adjusting your angle by keeping your speed bar onto the level that you want, and then just sort of adjusting, micro adjusting as you go along with a different level of speed. So the Chili 5, I think it's an ideal glider for somebody, especially if they're stepping up from a low or mid B and they're wanting to go up into the high B class, but don't want something that's too demanding or too sporty and active feeling, and they prefer something that's kind of got a more reassuring feeling about it, then that's a perfect candidate. Also, somebody who's got a high B glider and got maybe one of the higher, sportier end of high Bs and find it a bit much, they might find that a Chili 5 suits them better. And likewise, similarly, if you're a pilot that's flying a sports class glider and you find that a bit too sporty, and you prefer something that's got less pilot demands, that's more comfortable, then the Chili 5 is a great choice. So overall, the Skywalk Chili 5, I think it's an excellent high B wing. I'm really impressed with it. It's a very great all-round high B wing, I find. It's kind of, the pilot demands around the middle of the B, at the high B class, so middle of high B, the performance is probably nearer the higher end, the top end of the high Bs that I've flown, which is most of them. Very impressed, very nice glider. If you're a pilot that really likes a glider that's very agile and very nimble, then you might find the Chili 5 is kind of lacking a little bit in that area. So it's not that it's, you know, it's got moderate agility, it's not slow, but it's not a very agile glider. It's much more of a very reassuring, steady feeling, smooth feeling glider. So if you like that, that's great. But if you want a glider that's sporty and agile, then you might find the Chili 5 is a little bit, you know, you want a bit more sportiness and agility than that. Also, if you like a glider that talks to you quite a bit and gives more feedback, then its feedback is moderate, a bit dampened. So again, you might prefer something that's a bit more feedbacky, a bit more that talks to you more. But as I say again, the Chili 5 it's got a nice moderate level of agility. It does tell you what's happening in the air. One very serious criticism I have to say. So what is it? And that is, the brakes have got poppers. I prefer magnets.
Oh no, not poppers.
Yeah. Are you a popper or a magnet man or woman? I'm a magnet man. How about you? Popper man? Popper woman? Magnet man? Magnet woman? Tell us in the comments below. Well, I hope you've enjoyed this review of the Skywalk Chili 5. As much as I've enjoyed flying the Chili 5 and doing this review. If you've got any questions that you'd like to fire at us or just chat with other viewers, then stick a comment below, and look forward to seeing you in the next one. Bye. Good day's work done. Thank you.